Dear Ned, well, here I am at Captain's Cove Amusement Park, about to try to figure out what's behind all the weird things that have been happening here lately. First, a horse just disappeared off the carousel one night.
Oh.
Then a little later, the carousel started spinning around all by itself in the dead of night, as if it was haunted or something. And then
haunted
last
or
week,
something.
The roller coaster suddenly stopped in mid-ride for no apparent reason. Nobody was seriously hurt, but the park was shut down until the city knows for sure what caused the accident. I'm here because Paula Santos, the park's owner, is a friend of Dad's. She's putting me up at the Captain's Quarters Hotel, which is next to the park. I'm supposed to head over there right now and meet with a security guard named Harlan Bishop. I hope I don't let Paula down. Wish me luck. Ever yours, Nancy. P.S. There's a rumor going around that the park is cursed. Creepy, huh?
Creepy, huh? Captain's Quarters Hotel. I have a cell phone! Isn't this the first time she has a cell phone? Hardy? Home? Biss? Paula? Okay, we should start with Paula, I think. Just call her that we arrived.
Paula Santos.
Hello, Miss Santos. It's Nancy Drew.
Hello. Have you been out to the park?
No, not yet. I thought I'd check in with you first.
You're all set. I told the guard at the main gate to keep an eye out for you. His name's Harlan Bishop. All the rides are shut down except for the carousel. I thought you might need to see it in action. But please, take a good look at the roller coaster, even if you can't ride it.
Okay.
What did the police find when they looked at it?
They looked around for 5 minutes, then left.
Nokia Nancy.
The insurance company was going to investigate. Why should they?
They looked around for 5 minutes and then left. Said as long as the insurance company was going to investigate, why should they? I can get into the park through the main gate.
So I can get into the park through the main gate?
Harlan will be watching for you. Oh, and from now on, call me Paula.
All right. Goodbye, Paula.
Okay. I guess maybe we should just have a look first. This dolphin. What a background. Things to do. Oh, you have a checklist here. Nice. Check out the roller coaster, check out the carousel, head over to the park. Okay. Flag game. Oh. Oh, there's three of these. Oh! Oh, okay. Ah, I see. Okay. I need to redo this. I can do better. Nice. Just making sure I'm not missing any. Oh, do I get time from- Oh, I get time from making combos. Oh, then I'm gonna fucking rock this game. Oh, fuck, there was another one. This is a cool one. I like this game. It's very me. There's these. Oh, there. Damn, look at me go! I think it's going pretty well. What do you think is the high score? I can't find any. There's a lot of twos. But where is number three? Do you think it'll tell me if there's no combinations left? You can shuffle. Oh, you can even do that as well. Oh, the goal is 10K. Okay. It's pretty easy when you can like shuffle them however you like that quickly and easily. I'm used to that SNES game where you can only like switch them when they're next to each other. Ooh, big one. Bam. I made a 5 combo, bitches. Nice. How am I doing? 8K. 2 minutes left. Easy. I can do this. How many times can you shuffle? Unlimited? Oh yeah, there are 5 of these. Nice. Bam. Oh, so close. So close. I did it. Do I get anything for it? That was it. Win! No outgoing mail. I guess I don't have any friends. Welcome, Nancy. Thank you for your subscription to Sassy Detective Online, the electronic tip service for the modern detective. Check your inbox often. Tips will be arriving almost as fast as you can read them. Subscription department, Sassy Detective Online. Okay, do we have a suitcase?
A room service menu. All right.
Nice. Oh my god. Comic Sans. Pasta and veggie platter, hamburger platter, Captain's Cove fun day. I want it. Grandma Poseidon's sweet treats. You can get milk for 75 cents. Oh, those were different times. But, you know, people also made less money back in the day. My, I'm sure you guys have the same thing, but my parents always were like, saying how phony. My parents are always like, oh my god, 1 euro for an ice cream? Like, back in my day, you would get ice cream for 20 cents. And then, my mom would always be like, but, you know, you make this much now as a teenager at your little job. Where when I was a teenager, I only made this much. And then my parents were also like, oh my god, you make so much money back in my day. So it just gets more expensive as we go. Seaside fun and excitement. Captain's Cove. Nothing in New Jersey beats Captain Cove's amusement park.
Ralph Kessler.
Who's that? One of the first rides at the park was a carousel created by famed woodcarver Ralph Kessler. Okay. Completed in... Oh, you know what? I bet there's supposed to be a treasure stored in one of the horses. That's why one of them disappeared. They probably stole one. Completed in 1914, the carousel and its band organ are still operational. To this day, carousel connoisseurs swear that riding one of the wild-eyed steeds that Kessler carved is an experience that borders on eerie. For more information, call 609-555-9704. Should I write that down? Fun Pass, Demons of the Deep Haunted House. Ooh. Title Terror Roller Coaster. Midway Games. Okay, cool. Can I check out my site suitcase? No. Well, I think that does it then for the hotel. Oh, there's a closet. Oh, bathroom. Obviously. Why would I use an ironing?
I need to turn the iron on.
What would I want to iron? Turn it back off. Good to know. Okay, I think that's it. Oh, we're going straight to the amusement park.
Please turn immediately and enter the whale's mouth directly to her left. Thank you.
Sure. Ahoy, mateys!
Well, from the way you just marched right on in here past all those sorry we're closed signs, you're either who I think you are or you're one determined gatecrasher.
If you think I'm Nancy Drew, you're right.
That's a relief. It's too early in the day to go sicking the cops on anybody. I'm Harlan Bishop.
Okay. Must be pretty boring around here with the park closed.
Are you the only security guard on duty now?
I begged Miss Santos to keep me on while the park's closed. Even agreed to a pay cut.
Oh. Wow. You must really like
your job. You must really like your job.
I've only worked here for a couple of weeks. I figured staying on while the park was closed would help me get up to speed on all the equipment and such.
Only a couple weeks. Suspicious.
Where did you work before you came here?
Oh, I worked in a store.
Oh, so shady. Store,
you know, as a security guard. In Flemington. Not around here.
So is this your first encounter with a haunted amusement park ride?
Somebody swiped a horse off a carousel and now it's malfunctioning. The police don't think it's that big a deal, and frankly, neither do I.
What about the roller coaster?
Accidents happen. Of course, Ingrid will tell you that these so-called accidents are really the result of the park's karma getting bent out of shape by negative energy or some such gobbledygook.
Gobbledygook.
Who's Ingrid?
Ingrid Corey. You'll probably meet her. She's working during the shutdown, too. She's the park's chief engineer. Believes in all this wacky new age psychobiogenic stuff. Like if you eat food served by a waiter who's in a bad mood, you'll get scurvy or something.
Oh.
Where can I find her?
First things first. You won't be meeting her or Elliot Chen, the park's art director, until after you go see the park's bookkeeper, Joy Trent. Miss Santos's orders. Joy pays all the bills, so she knows pretty much everything that's going on. Plus, she'll give you an access card. Miss Santos wants you to have the run of the place.
Okay.
That would certainly help.
Wait, hang on. I know Joy won't give you one of these, so I will. Here you go. It's a Captain's Cove fun card. Lets you ride the rides and play the games on the midway.
Sure, thanks.
Come back to me if you burn through that one and need another.
Oh, okay.
Why wouldn't Joy give me one of these?
Well, see, Joy's just kind of joyless. It had never occurred to her that you might want to have some fun while you're here. Of course, she's a newbie too, like me. Maybe she'll come around. Anyway, here's a map of the park. I put an X where Joy's office is.
Okay.
I see you have a security camera trained on the carousel. Does that mean you got the theft of that carousel horse on tape?
We didn't start monitoring the carousel until after the theft. But we do have one of those so-called hauntings on tape. Want to see it?
Yeah.
That'd be great!
I got the tape right here, all queued up. I played it for the police. Like I said before, they weren't real impressed.
So it just starts moving?
On the tape, at least. The band organ started up when the carousel did. Stayed on for about 30 seconds, then stopped.
Is that where the horse is missing on the right? There's like one dot instead of a pole. Did you notice a burst of static just before the carousel started to turn?
Did you notice that burst of static just before the carousel started to turn?
Probably just a glitch in the tape. We use them over and over.
Have you tried to prove your screwed up wiring theory?
I ain't no cop, But now that you're here, maybe you can prove it for me.
May I see that tape of the carousel haunting again?
I got the tape right here, all queued up.
So we can see it multiple times if we want to. Yeah, you can see a little space missing on the left of that carriage that's on the front row. There's like a little circle. That's where the horse used to be. No sound, though.
I'll see you around.
Go get him.
Anything else here? That music. Nothing I can click on. I guess it's all for later. Harlan. Why would I want to go in? Hey, Evie.
Please don't open that.
Sorry, bad habit.
Bad habit. She has always been nosy. What a cute map. Can we go here? Little Cuppy Play Pond. A guppy.
Hello, are you Nancy?
You remind me of someone. Who does she look like? Is it the girl from Resident Evil 4? Why can't I think of her name? Sherry Birkin. Oh, yeah, actually, that's much better. Yeah, she looks like Sherry Birkin. Are you Joy?
Yes, I am. You're Joy?
Joy Trent. Sorry about the mess.
Ashley Graham, yeah.
So, I'm supposed to give you an access card.
No hurry. If you're in the middle of something, please go ahead and finish up.
No hurry. If you're in the middle of something, please go ahead and finish up.
That's okay. I'd just as soon get this little farce over.
Excuse me?
You're only here because it makes it look like Paula Santos had nothing to do with any of this curse garbage.
Are you saying she did have something to do with it?
I've seen how Paula runs the park. All she wants is to get more and more people through that gate. And what better way to do that than with a carousel that's allegedly haunted?
But why would she sabotage the roller coaster? She can't make any money with a park shut down.
She probably just didn't know the park would be shut down.
Is Ms. Santos aware of the way you feel about her?
Of course not. I don't want to get fired. Besides, nobody's been hurt. Except that glorified con artist who claims his neck got injured, Lance Huffington. And the truth is, Paula offered me this job because she knew I needed the money. And I'm not entirely ungrateful. My father died recently. His estate is in bankruptcy. He used to be co-owner of the park. 2 years ago, he suffered a huge financial setback, and he had to sell his share to Paula. When he died 2 months ago, he was flat broke. Paula could have bailed him out, but she didn't. Frankly, I think the reason she hired me was guilt.
Right. I'm supposed to get an access card from you?
Here you go. That should get you into all the private areas of the park. But if you run into problems, don't come to me. Ask the chief engineer, Ingrid Corey. Her office is by the haunted house. The only other people in the park right now are Harlan Bishop and the art director, Elliot Chin. His studio is right by the treasure chest souvenir shop. But try not to bug him.
Why? Is he temperamental?
He's behind in his work and needs to catch up. Ms. Santos has been getting on my case about it. Well, I think you have everything, so if you'll excuse me?
Oh, right. Thanks for all your help. Sorry if I disturbed you.
Man, Nancy, you're too nice to her.
Okay, if I peek in here?
Go ahead and look around. Excuse all the clutter. I'm still trying to get this place organized.
What is that? Whoa, is that their handwriting and then it has a thing under it? CCAP has agreed to sell the horse. The horse will be removed from the ride on August 3rd. Must be replaced immediately. Please find out how much this will cost and when you can deliver it. I need this information by end of day Thursday.
Looks like stenography.
Stenography?
It's a memo about one of the carousel horses being sold. I wonder which horse.
What is stenography? Shorthand? What's that? I don't know it. Old way of writing before computers. Writing things faster. Huh. Galaxy Ballroom, Sheldon Rousseau. The world's greatest beachfront ballroom. Conductor Shaw bids. Anything else? The Sheldon Rousseau's carousel. Original Sheldon Rousseau Galaxy Ballroom.
The haunted house used to be a ballroom. How's that for irony?
Ah. Haunted house upon completion. Ooh. Victim of coaster accident files $1 million lawsuit against park. By Monica Clark, Cove Crier staff reporter. Lance Huffington, 37, is suing the Captain Cove Amusement Park for $1 million as a result of neck injuries he allegedly suffered while riding the roller coaster at the park last week. Huffington, a salesperson at Mady's pre-owned car company, was a passenger on the Tidal Terror roller coaster when it suddenly lost power, slipped backwards, and stopped. He claims that the sudden stop caused his head to snap backwards, then forwards, and that this whiplash effect caused severe trauma to soft tissue in his neck. The lawsuit seeks compensation for medical costs, pain and suffering, and emotional distress. Police say that no injuries, including Huffington's, were reported at the time of the incident. Huffington alleges that it's not uncommon for whiplash victims to be unaware of their injuries until later. The next day, that's when it hit me. I woke up and couldn't move. The pain was so bad, said Huffington. It's still bad, and the doctors say I may have to wear this neck brace for the rest of my life. I'm not trying to soak anybody. It's just what I just want what's fair. The owner of the park, Paula Santos, declined to comment on the lawsuit. The park was closed immediately after the accident to allow a thorough inspection of the roller coaster. Cause of the accident has still not been determined. Shorthand is something that gets used still during court cases when the talking happens so fast that you just put down a few buttons and can make words depending on how it's connected. That's interesting. I didn't know that was a thing. Blast off in the night rocket! Only at Captain's Cove Amusement Park. Can I read this?
Maybe I should give Detective Paris a call.
1983. Mike DeSalle holds the jewelry he found in the padding of the orbiter, according to Detective Paris. More hidden valuables could turn up in the park. Parkgoer finds hidden treasure at Captain's Cove. By Dilly Dally. Dilly Dally. The orbiter turned into Mike DeSalle's favorite amusement park ride yesterday when he found close to $50,000 worth of jewelry hidden in the padding that's lined the ride's backrest. I felt something sharp when I strapped in, said 19-year-old DeSalle. By the time the ride was over, I thought for sure whatever it was, it totally stuck itself into my shoulder. Assuming someone had placed rocks in the padding as a joke, DeSalle examined the backrest, found a small slit at the top edge, and through it managed to pull out the offending objects. Three necklaces, a pearl necklace, and two jewel-studded gold bracelets. I knew they were real right away, he said. Fakes just don't sparkle like that. He turned his find over to the police, who quickly discovered that the jewelry was indeed real. It had been among the items stolen when a thief broke into the safe at the Captain's Quarters Hotel 3 years ago. Despite the fact that the man suspected of the theft is currently serving time in the state penitentiary, for an unrelated crime, none of the stolen items have ever been found, until yesterday. The man in charge of the investigation 3 years ago, veteran police detective K.G. Paris, recalls that the thief made his getaway by running through the park. Paris now suspects that the reason the loot has never turned up is because the thief stashed the jewelry in various places throughout the park, so he could return for it days, months, even years later.
Looking for someone?
Hi. Wow. You must be...
If you're Ingrid Corey, not anymore.
That's me. Ordinarily, I don't do the hands-on work, and I'd be able to shake your hand, Ms...
I'm sorry. Nancy Drew. I'm helping Ms. Santos discover what's behind these carousel hauntings. Okay if I ask you some questions?
Sure. Oh, my. You've got B3 issues.
B3?
I do?
Vitamin B3. Niacin. The vibe you're giving off tells me you're low. Nothing that some natural peanut butter on a slice of whole wheat bread once a day won't fix.
Well, I just walked in a door. Can you imagine? You walk into a room, meet a new person, and the person like looks at you. It's like, I know what's your problem. Vitamin D. You haven't seen the sun in a while, have you? I can smell it off of you.
Harlan Bishop mentioned that some of your beliefs concerning food were somewhat unconventional.
It just seems obvious to me that what you eat, as well as the psycho-spiritual conditions under which you eat it, results in what you are, that's all.
Psycho-spiritual conditions when you eat food.
Are you sure you're an engineer?
Got a Bachelor of Science degree from Ohio State and everything.
She's educated.
I like surprising people. Unpredictability is what makes life interesting.
Okay.
Miss Santos asked me to figure out why weird things have been happening around here lately.
What's to figure out? Someone stole a horse off the carousel and now the park is cursed.
Oh yeah, easy. Just a regular curse.
So you think this cursed thing is real?
The man who carved the horses, Kessler, he said if they were ever separated, bad luck would follow. And it has.
Do you think it's her? Do you think she's the one who is after the treasure, but she's just, like, throwing in the curse and the vitamin stuff to, like, throw you off? To be like, so you won't take her as seriously, but in the meantime, she's actually doing stuff in the background? Could I see the blueprints?
Could I see the blueprints of the roller coaster so you can show me exactly where on the track it stopped?
I've looked all over for those blueprints and can't find them anywhere.
And now she
I'm
can't
sure
find
one of the other
blueprints?
Engineers knows where they are, but I'm afraid I don't. Sorry.
How well do you know Harlan Bishop?
I know he's an ex-bouncer from Trenton. I also know it drives him nuts that this is one of the few places in the park he doesn't have a key for.
Any idea why someone would steal a horse off a carousel?
Money. I hear they can be very valuable.
Do you mind having to work during the shutdown?
Not a bit. Keeping those card readers functioning is practically a full-time job all by itself. Plus, I happen to adore my job.
She probably gets paid regardless whether the park is closed or not, so...
Thanks for your help.
No big deal.
No big deal. Ooh, whose workplace is this? Blueprints! Oh, hello.
I believe that's mine.
Right.
And a candle.
Sorry.
They're all pretty chill about me touching everything. Pandora 2XS Hybrid, open it up. A Porsche. Okay, now I really think it's her. She's already, like, she's so sure she's gonna find the treasure that she's already planning what to do with the money. I think it's her. That was Ingrid. So we met Harlan, Joy, then Ingrid, and then here's Elliot. She got a skirt out of here.
Hang on, I'll be right with you.
Take your time.
So this is the... Oh.
Out. And do not come back unless and until Joy Trent calls me. Okay?
Okay.
Wow. Oopsie. Okay, where should we go? The hotel is where we're staying. There's the haunted house. I guess we should probably start just with the carousel. Then there's a roller coaster and Midway Games. No high heels, spurs, or peg legs, please. That's cute. Do I use my access pass?
This takes a fun pass.
Let's go for a spin on the carousel. By the way, you have 4 fun credits left on your card. Enjoy the ride.
Card. Oh, I'm actually riding
the
ride.
Carousel will be starting in 3 seconds, so hang on tight. And don't forget to try for the brass ring.
Yeehaw!
A free ride to holder of brass ring. Oh, this is actually really creepy. I feel like...
Here comes the brass ring. Get ready. Got it.
Nice. I feel like this is... You could do great indie horror like this, where every time you go around, something changes.
Here it comes again.
Oh, I clicked it. The fuck? Well, I got one ring. Oh, I can't stay on it. It just auto-walks me away. Well, I have a ring. She didn't inspect anything. I thought we would, like, I don't know, like, check the where the horse was stolen and stuff. Swimmer's itch. Please insert your fun pass.
If I play this game, I can win a seahorse.
You're about to play Swimmer's Itch. You have 3 fun credits left on your card. Your mission is to get the swimmer to the beach.
Get the swimmer to the beach before the hurricane hits. Move the swimmer from right to left by clicking on the swimmer or to the, or on the obstacles. Okay. Vertical objects move up and down, horizontal, left and right. Square objects can move in any direction. Keep an eye on the weather forecast to the right. If you don't reach the beach by the time the forecast says hurricane, you lose. Win all 3 levels and you get a seahorse token. Okay. Let's do medium. Okay. Ah, so I just clicked them. Like that? Okay, that was it. There. Okay. I think I did well. Okay.
Oh, looks like it's out of order.
Prize-o-matic. Insert tokens. Okay, so we have this one. What is it? Wait, what did she do? She knocked something over? So it's something that gives us more reach. What is this one? Whale, dolphin, trout, shrimp, fish fry. Can I play this one?
This takes a fun pass.
Time to play Squid Toss. In case you were wondering, you have 2 fun credits left on your card. Catapult the squid through the hoop.
Okay, how do I... Oh, that was too much. Wait, that was it? How was I supposed to do it? You wanna try again?
Ahoy, matey! Welcome to the squid toss!
We can always get
after
a new
this,
card.
You'll just have 1 fun credit left on your card. Catapult the squid through the hoop.
So that was too high? Oh, can I do this as well? Oh. Ah. Okay. I can't tell. Oh, not loud enough. Hard enough.
How about a game of squid toss? Uh-oh, you are using your last fun credit, so I'm keeping your card. Well, that's no problem. Just get a new one. Catapult the squid through the hoop.
Okay. So this one we figured out. This one is this. So then this one... Do I do a 2 or a 1? I think 2. We'll do dolphin. Hit. Oh, it was too far to the left. Right. Damn it. Okay. We'll come back later. Talk to Harlan for a new card.
Hey, Nancy, what's up?
Fun pass.
I seem to have used up all the fun on my fun pass. Did you say I could get another one?
I certainly did. Here you go. Enjoy.
Tank.
May I see that tape of the carousel haunting again?
I didn't see what I clicked
on.
I
got the tape right here, all queued up.
It's not going to show us anything. It's like someone did something to the camera. That's why it, like, buzzed or was static beforehand.
I'm afraid I got off on the wrong foot with Elliot. I spilled paint all over something he'd been working on.
Ooh, not good. The guy's already about a month behind in his work.
Mm-hmm. Any idea why he's so far behind?
He's a procrastinator. Doesn't really like to work, so he does whatever he can to avoid it. Puts things off till the last minute. Me, I get stuff done right away. You do too, I'll bet.
Well, I try. Has he always been behind?
I guess he was doing okay up until about a month ago. Way I hear it, if he doesn't get caught up, like, fast, he's gonna be waving bye-bye, like, soon.
I'll see you around.
Have fun.
Hmm. Procrastinator or looking for treasure. So someone said we need to see Joy again? Oh.
Who are you, and what are you doing?
Who said that?
Oh. I said that. Over here, on top of the cabinet. Keep going. Over here. Please identify yourself.
I'm a detective named Nancy Drew, and you are?
I am
Miles, the Magnificent Memory Machine.
I receive and process video and audio input and make appropriate pre-programmed verbal responses.
Who programmed you?
It is my turn to ask a question,
Nancy Drew.
Why are you here when Joy is not?
I need to leave a message for her.
As a matter of fact, I need to leave a message for her.
There is a pad for leaving messages on the desk.
So, who programmed you?
Responding to the non-Joy entity is an unnecessary drain on my power units and is heretofore disallowed.
What does that mean? Hello? Miles? I guess it means he's not going to talk to me anymore.
Sounds like he's owned by Joy. Pad on the desk. But I can't use it, though. Oh, maybe if I go to the back.
I can use this to leave a note for Joy to call Elliot.
Okay. Anything else here? Anything now that we can snoop? We can't! Damn it. This place is kind of creepy. Okay. What else should we do? We haven't checked the roller coaster yet, have we? Oh, the eyes are moving.
Hello?
Hi, Nancy. It's Paula Santos. You know, I just had a thought. There's a newspaper article and photo in Joy's office that I want you to be sure to take a look at. They're in a frame on the wall.
I already looked at it.
I may have seen them. What are they about?
They're a little piece of park history. The guy in the photo found a bunch of jewels that had been stolen in a heist years ago and stashed away on one of the rides at Captain's Cove.
Yeah, we read about
Police
that.
Said there was a good chance more jewels would turn up.
Maybe that's why someone stole that carousel.
That's what
horse,
we were saying.
Because there were jewels hidden inside it.
My thoughts exactly. I called the detective that was in charge of the investigation back then. His name is KJ Paris. He's going to call you. Oops, I gotta run. I just wanted to give you a heads up.
All right. Goodbye, Paula.
Okay.
Hmm. I wonder what the deal is with this red tag. It's locked.
So we can't get in here.
This takes an employee access card.
I thought this was going to give us access to everything. Huh. We can investigate it. Ah. Thanks, chat. So this is where it was taken from. But nothing here. Oh. Moon glow. Oh, I bet there's a hint about I bet there's a treasure in one of the horses. And like, it'll say which name, like which horse we need to look for. Carousel was created by Rolf Gesser in 1914. What? Not good enough, huh? They gave me a lousy access card. Damn. I love the sneaky music. Can I go this way? I can't. That's about as far as I go. Maybe you should ask Harlan about getting access to things?
Hey Nancy, what's up?
The card reader outside the roller coaster doesn't work. It's got this red tag on it.
Means the power's been shut off. Ingrid must be working on it. Go talk to her. She probably took a break to go meditate and forgot what she was doing.
Does that sort of thing happen a lot with her?
Oh yeah. And good luck finding her. These mind relaxation breaks of hers sometimes last for hours.
She's so sus.
May I see that tape of the carousel haunting again?
Damn it, I keep accidentally
right
clicking
here,
on it.
Queued up.
We've looked at this 5 times now.
I'll see you around.
Sounds good.
Ingrid.
Hello?
This is Detective K.J. Paris, Captain's Cove Police Department. Paula Santos asked me to call you. Said it concerned that heist out at Captain's Quarters 23 years ago.
Well, I was thinking maybe the reason that horse was stolen off the carousel at Captain's Cove 2 weeks ago was because somebody thought there were jewels from that heist inside it.
Never occurred to me, but it's possible, I suppose. The thief's name was Chaz Dunning. Died in prison about a year ago. I'll tell you what. I'll make some calls, try to see if there was somebody he confided in before he died. Somebody who was recently released.
That would be fantastic.
Well, as soon as I know something, you'll know something.
Thanks, Detective Paris. It was great talking to you.
Ditto.
Ditto. How nice. She's just
Hello,
here.
Nancy. Still on the case, I see.
I'd like to take a closer look at the roller coaster, but the access card reader has been red tagged. Harlan says it's because you're working on it?
Right. I was in the process of upgrading its main circuitry board. I'm afraid you're going to have to wait until I finish here. Unless you'd like to do it for me.
The way she is with, like, the vitamins and stuff makes me think of a colleague my mom had, like, way in the past. And the colleague was like... The colleague was always, like, complaining about stomach pains and, like, not feeling very well. But then, at the same time, she thought... She was like, I don't know what it could be. Like, I'm so healthy. I drink 3 raw eggs every morning. And my mom was like, you shouldn't drink raw eggs. Like, no wonder your stomach is fucked. Said it in a nicer way than that. But she was like, she was so convinced that that was so healthy that she just was like, that cannot be it. And she was so stubborn and she never fixed it. And she just had stomach aches for all the years that she worked there. Because she had 3 raw eggs every day. That's what this reminds me of. Like, they're so convinced of what they're doing is right. That if you're like, I think I should get it checked out by an actual doctor. She's like, no, your aura is telling me that that's not it.
Do you really think I could handle it?
It's not exactly brain surgery. All you have to do is follow the schematic inside the reader. Here's the new macro resistor.
Oh, wow.
When you see the board, you'll be able to see where it goes. You'll need to solder it in place.
Damn.
Which means you're going to have to get my soldering gun from Elliot Chen. Here's
the
handbook I put together. If you have questions about park-related electronics, it'll answer them. Keep it as long as you like. When you're all done,
That's
remove
forthcoming
the red tag
of her.
And take it to Harlan. That way he'll know it's safe to turn the power back on to the reader.
That's not my cell phone. It must be yours. Are you going to answer it?
No, that would be rude. I'll just call them back. So, once you get that tool from Elliot, you should be all set.
She's so suspicious. Who's calling her?
I don't seem to be having much luck using my access card. Am I doing something wrong?
I deactivated most of the readers because of the shutdown. Soon as I get done here, I'll get them online again. Sorry. Hey, if you come across a pair of pliers, hang on to them, okay? Mine are missing. Someone must have walked off with them.
That sounds like she just shut down the park so that we can't get in and see, like, the mess she made somewhere. Or, like, because she's, like, digging around somewhere and she doesn't want anyone else to go in.
Any advice on how to go about fixing the Midway game that's broken?
It needs to be reprogrammed. Open up the back. Should be some instructions on the clipboard. Check that handbook I gave you if they're too cryptic for you. But you'll also need the plug-in keyboard. And unfortunately, I have no idea where it is. One of my guys probably left it in the park somewhere.
Yeah, I'm also thinking it might be too obvious that it's her.
Remember,
maybe she's the red herring. Don't forget those vitamins. I do say that to a lot of people, though. Whenever someone's like, man, I don't know what's wrong, I'm so low energy, I always say, like, it's probably vitamin D, because so many of us are just inside all the time. And then a lot of times they actually go to the doctor and get it checked out, and then they're like, it was vitamin D. I kind of want to try that game again.
Catapult the squid through the hoop.
Through the hoop. Okay, so one, shrimp, go. Done. Okay, so one, dolphin, go. Hell yeah. Okay, that's two. Ooh, this seems like a hard one. Let's go whale. Hell yeah! Got token, bitches! Okay, what do we get with the whale one? Is it this one? Oh, out of stock. Damn it. We can get maybe this one. We haven't seen the other token yet, right? Yeah, these. But this one's out of service. Maybe we can fix it? Got the stun, but had to fight the power relay switch to work right. Nick F. After successfully upgrading the hardware on the circuit board, Crawlmeister arcade game will not function and will display an error message on the front panel video screen. Need service. Hardware upgrade must be added to the Crawlmeister arcade game code. In the back of each Crawlmeister arcade game is a small video screen that contains the programming code. Use a Crawlmeister portable keyboard to plug into the monitor. Oh, that's the one that we didn't have yet, right? Okay, so we'll just leave this for now. Fight the power. we need to talk to Elliot again. Hopefully he likes us more this
time.
Hi, Nancy. KJ Paris. I got some preliminary info on that jewel thief. You know Chaz Dunning?
Great, let's hear it.
Okay. Before he died, he got to be real good buddies with his cellmate at New Jersey State Prison. And his cellmate was paroled less than 2 months ago.
Do you know the guy's name?
Well, apparently he's used a lot of aliases. The guy I talked to wasn't sure which name he was released under, but he did give me a description. Dark hair, medium build, clean shaven, heavy Jersey accent. Like I said, I'm still in the process of making calls.
Need a picture.
I just thought I'd let you know what I had so far.
Thanks, Detective. You've been a big help.
The security guard? It could be.
Well,
hey, dude.
Miss Destructo returns.
You talked to Joy?
Imagine my surprise when she told me you're a detective.
Amateur detective.
I hear you're out to solve the curse of Captain's Cove.
What do you think caused the roller coaster accident?
That was no accident. It was sabotage.
Why do you say that?
That's
because
what I'm thinking.
I'm pulling your leg, that's why. Come on. What do I know? I'm just an artist. Go ask our naturopathic engineer person.
Naturopathic. Do you have any idea who stole the horse off the carousel?
Do you have any idea who stole that horse off the carousel?
Somebody who's into junk.
That's odd. Ingrid said carousel horses can be very valuable.
Well, when they're the original horses, they can be valuable, yes. But I was talking about the one that was stolen. It was not an original. Around 18, 20 years ago, somebody bought one of the horses off the carousel.
The guy who owned the park back then commissioned some hack to replace it.
Could it be in the one that was bought that has the treasure in it?
And that's the horse that was stolen, the replacement?
Right.
The fact that the park is shut down must be kind of a relief for you.
You mean because I'm behind in my work? I'd be lying if I said the shutdown wasn't helping me get caught up. Meeting deadlines has never been my forte. But I certainly hope you're not suggesting that I arranged for the park to be shut down by somehow manufacturing this curse thing, because that would be ridiculous.
Ingrid said you have her soldering gun. I need to get it from you, if that's okay.
You bet. Here you go. Been meaning to return it to her, but I've been a little busy.
Great. Thanks. Do you see much of the other people who are working during the shutdown? Like Joy Trent or that security guard, Harlan Bishop?
Nah. Joy Trent? She's like invisible even when she's visible, if you get my drift. And that rent-a-cop, I've got no desire to see anything of him.
Why do you say that?
Rent-a-cop.
Dude is way too eager to make my business his business, that's all.
I'll let you get back to work.
They don't like
each
other. What's that?
Could I have some of these tissue strips?
Be my guest.
Tissue strips! Nothing else? Weird. Adhesives, bunch of things. Okay, so now we should be able to get in here, right?
This takes an employee access card.
Where do we fix the thing?
I haven't finished repairing this yet. Better not take the tag until I fix this.
Ah. Oh god. Call service to request upgrade for card reader below schematic for the circuit as it currently stands. The resistors are in parallel. Waiting for delivery of macro resistor. I'll split the circuit to allow easy soldering for macro resistor once it comes in. Krollmeister called and said that the total resistance for the upgrade has to be 15 ohms. That said, the macro resistor will give 5 ohms of resistance, so whoever hooking up the thing should hook the resistors in series. Okay, we need 15. Oh god. Maybe I should look at that book. Time to time, manufacturers of the arcade games on the Midway will provide us with updates in either the hardware or software. Hardware updates usually require a software update so that the program is aware of the new hardware. When adding a new hardware, follow the manufacturer's instructions. See the section of soldering and circuits for additional information. Oh god. The most important rule in working with electrical equipment is to make sure that power sources are disconnected or turned off before working. Okay, got that. First caller, second caller, third caller, tolerance. Resistors reduce the amount of voltage or current in an electrical circuit. Think of a resistor as a dam holding back the electrical power. Resistors have different values. The value of the resistor is measured in ohms. Yeah, so ours is 5, the green one. The amount of total resistance depends on how the resistors are placed. Okay, several resistors are placed in series. Total resistance is the sum of the resistor values. 10, 30, 100. Total resistance is 140. Okay. Resistors placed in parallel, separate circuits that later meet up, have a more complex formula to compute total resistance on a circuit. Consult with your manager on this issue. Okay. So where does this one go? Here? Oh, there. So it needs to be 15. So wait, this is a red one? So it's 30? And that one's 10. Oh, so we don't need this one. We need this one, the top one. So we'll leave that disconnected then. I think. Okay, so this connects to this one. That should be it.
There, that looks right.
I did it! I surprised myself there.
Oops, no power.
Oh, right. Now we need to go back to Ingrid's for the power.
Hello, Nancy. How goes it?
How well do you know Elliot Chen?
Not very. But I've noticed he has a very strange aura. Very dark around the edges. Odd for an artist. But then, it's nowhere near as dark as Joy's. Her aura's a mess.
Why do you think that is?
She's hiding something. And she's hiding from something. Something very big and very dark. Plus, she eats way too many carbs. To say nothing of pencils.
Your aura's a mess. Too many carbs.
Thanks for your help.
Remember, carb filth. Niacin.
How dare you eat carbs? Girl, your aura's a mess. I bet it's carbs. Is she here? Oh, whoops.
I really do need to get this work done.
Sorry.
Right. Sorry.
Where do we go for power? Do you think Harlan does it? Oh, right. She said remove the tag and
hey,
then Harlan
Nancy,
knows
what's
that
up?
It's fine.
Could you turn the power back on to the
right,
card
thanks.
Reader outside the roller coaster? It's all fixed. Here's the tag.
You bet. I'll just switch the circuit back on and you'll be all set.
Ingrid said you told her that you were a bouncer before you came to work here. In Trenton, not Flemington.
Right. I was. For a while. I've held almost every guard-type job there is. Lived in a lot of different places, too. Trenton, Jersey City, Flemington, Cape May.
Hmm. May I see that
tape? Oh, ah, I did it again!
Again?
I got oh, the tape
God.
Right here, all queued up.
Okay, now we should be able to get in. Nice. Hell yeah, we're in, baby. Oh, it's a kitty. And... is that red door, red handprint supposed to be there? That's really cool, these decorations. What's this? Emergency stop. Roller coaster.
This looks like one of Joy's.
Oh, Joy was here, huh? At the emergency stop? Interesting. Can't really go any further, though. What is this?
Ow! I'm trapped!
What? Oh no, we're about to die, aren't we?
To get my foot loose, I need to switch the track somehow. Looks like I have to reconnect these wires.
Oh god! But how? Which one goes where?
Now I can turn the power on and see if there are six ways to connect these. I'll just have to try them all.
Oh god.
That's not right.
Oh god.
Ooh. You were electrocuted?
That's what Harlan said must have happened. I was out cold when he found me.
I can't afford to have you blundering around the park getting into accidents, Nancy. My insurance rates are high enough. In other words, you're off the case.
Oh my god. I didn't die, but I immediately got taken off. Second chance, please! Oh my god, it puts me here? Okay, let's try some more connections.
Uh-oh.
We can maybe check the book.
To get my foot loose, I need to switch the track
Not
somehow.
Right now.
No. Okay, no time
Looks
for
like
that.
I have to reconnect these wires.
Let's try this.
Now I can turn the... There are six ways to connect
Okay,
these.
That's not it.
You were electrocuted?
That's what Harlan said must have happened.
Now
I
just
out cold when he
died instantly.
I can't afford to have you blundering around the park getting into accidents.
Remember
Nancy.
To turn
My
them off.
Insurance rates are high
oh,
enough.
That's what
In
I do
words,
wrong.
You're off the case.
Looks like I have to reconnect these wires.
So let's try this.
Now I can turn the power off. There are six ways to connect these.
Okay, turn it off.
I'll just have to try them all.
Oh god. Wait, did I try this?
That's not right.
Oh my god. I tried this, right?
That's still not right.
Oh my god, you're gonna die. Let go! Let go of these wires! Why am I not- Oh, there we go. Let's try. You're so dead.
Still not right.
You're so dead.
Try again.
Oh my god. How many ways are there? I tried straight through.
Try again.
I feel like I tried all of these already. Did I do it? Okay. We did it. Okay. I forgot. I need to save. I always forget. Escaped death. Now, is there any- there's nothing else we can look at. We just got a pencil. So I guess we should ask Joy if it's
hers.
Need
something?
Do you by any chance know how to read shorthand?
Sorry, sure don't.
Sure don't.
Do you ever talk to the other people who are working during the shutdown?
I'm not very good at socializing. I couldn't even tell you what any of them look like, quite frankly. I go to work, I work, I go home. That's pretty much my life.
Someone activated the roller coaster while I was standing on the tracks just now. I barely managed to escape.
Really? Are you sure it was on purpose? Maybe you accidentally tripped a switch or something.
It was no accident. Does this pencil I found by the tracks look familiar?
That looks like one of mine. But I didn't leave it there. I mean, just because you found one of my pencils, that hardly proves I'm guilty of something.
Maybe someone was trying to...
While you were gone, the Nancy Drew entity came in here and snooped.
You were snooping around in here?
Well, I came in here looking for you, yes, but...
An analysis of sensory input shows that the Nancy Drew entity entered the immediate area during your absence and exhibited non-random seeking behavior.
Mm-hmm.
I was just trying to do the job Ms. Santos asked me to do. I didn't know I was being watched.
My father was a frustrated inventor. After he died, I discovered that in his study. In his will, he said he made it just for me. I don't have room in my apartment, so I brought him here. I keep him covered when I know I'm going to have company. As you noticed, he can be kind of a
blabbermouth. Oh, that was under
the
sheet.
The word blabbermouth is without meaning to
Miles, the magnificent memory machine.
That's like a bicycle track on his head.
Why does he call himself the magnificent memory machine?
My father said he invented Miles in order to reacquaint me with my childhood. It always bothered him that I was never as happy-go-lucky as he was. What am I, Miles?
Joy Trent is a party-pooping stick in the mud.
So my father programmed him with a bunch of riddles designed to reconnect me with long-lost memories from my childhood.
That sounds fascinating.
I don't see it that way at all. I don't want to relive my childhood. My mother died when I was 4.
My mother died when I was really young, too. Maybe I could help you.
I should be mad that you were snooping around in here. But the truth is, I think it's neat that you're so gutsy.
Oh?
Especially since I'm so not gutsy. Oh, what the heck?
Not gutsy.
Okay, Miles, let's hear the first riddle.
Here is the first riddle. Listen carefully. To be told a truth long since put away, bring me the silvery remains of a 4-bit day.
I have no idea what he's talking about. I knew it would be a waste of time.
Don't give up yet. Maybe I'll turn up something in the course of my investigation.
Do what you want, but I'm not gonna hold my breath.
So that's something we can find around here? A 4-bit day. Okay, we've been on the roller coaster. All we found was a pencil. We've checked the games, but we need a keyboard. Checked out the carousel. Oh, maybe the power's on there again? Now that we did the other stuff?
Guess I'm gonna have to call Tink.
Do not touch anything. Oh yeah, we haven't called the other number either. Is Sending.
This is Tink. Sorry, I'm busy fishing, which means you're gonna have to call me back.
Hi, my name is Nancy Drew. My number is 523-555-4399. If you could call me back, I'd really appreciate it.
Okay, and then the other one was 9704. So which one is that that I wrote down? I don't think that one is in here. But maybe if I call it like that without the stuff in front of it.
We're sorry. Your call cannot be completed as dialed.
Okay.
Check the number and dial again. This is a recording.
Something's missing here.
Well, let's try... Oh, nope. Let's try the other side. Oh, the inside of a carousel. Weird. Ooh. Padlock combination. What is this?
Time to start crawling. This goes to the space underneath the carousel.
Whoa. Caution beyond this point. Creepy.
There's something up there. Looks like a letter.
Where? Oh.
I can't reach it.
Oh, I have the thing. Amelia Kessler. Wait, Kessler? The dude who made it, Kessler?
The ballroom? That's what was converted into the haunted house.
My dearest Amelia, the work goes slowly, but it goes. I just completed the fifth horse, my favorite so far. I call him Foxfire, which is a phosphorescent fungus that grows on rotting wood. I've always thought fondly of that name. Every night, music plays in the ballroom above my workshop. Every night, 100 feet scamper back and forth overhead. When I complained to Mr. Russo, he said that if I worked in the daytime like everyone else, there would be no music to bother me. He doesn't understand that I can only work when my world is as I feel. Dark, dangerous, unknowable. But you understand, my darling wife. You are the only person on Earth who has ever understood everything that can be understood about me. And I miss you terribly.
So, there was a door to Kessler's workshop by the radiator in what's now the haunted house.
The radiator still stands guard outside the door to my workshop, as cold and heavy as my heart, awaiting your return. You must come back to me, Amelia. Your father was loath to give me your address. I promised him things will be better, as I now promise you, if, when, you return. But what if you don't read this? What if it comes back unopened? Or worse, what if it never comes back, and neither do you? Your rejection would be unbearable. Perhaps I shall mail this letter tomorrow, but I know that I cannot mail it today, my beloved. I don't have the courage. I cannot take the risk. I love you too much. Yours alone forever, Wolf. Damn! Do you think there's still someone alive we could give that to? Let me think. The ballroom? Have we even... The haunted house? We haven't even been there yet! Whoa, that is so cool. The sounds. Keep going under the carousel to find something. Oh, I'll come back there.
What is that noise?
Oh, it sounds from below.
Sounds like it's coming from below.
The keyboard! Hey, nice. He's missing an arm. Oh, another tag. He's broken. Another thing we can fix. The radiator. Oh, there's something there.
That symbol looks familiar.
Symbol?
That symbol looks familiar. That symbol looks familiar.
Okay. Oh, there's a trap door here? Oh, I don't trust that. Okay, keep going under the carousel, someone said.
Wonder what that is.
Oh, that's it. Is that what you wanted me to find? Oh. Yeah? Okay, cool. Then I will go back out. Do you think I can use that already? Wonder if it needs more power or something.
It's locked.
That sound that's in the background, when it starts up, it sounds like Majora's Mask when it's like the last day and you're running out of time. There's like a high-pitched sound that it keeps reminding me of. Oh.
It's locked.
We need a key. An old one by the looks of it. Okay. Interesting. Okay. What do we have? We have the keyboard, so we could fix the arcade machine. We want to feel a bit more courageous now that we fixed
the keyboard is missing.
Okay, to update game, change function call online directly below. Game over is Barnacle Blast. If game over is zero something. Sue, I'm assuming your game function will always return 0, 1, or 2. If not, we're toast. Hit enter to save and run. Okay, let's have a read. Dress code? We need something on game code. When adding new software, the manufacturer will always provide instructions. Be sure to complete each line of code with a semicolon. Place all parameters in parentheses. Access to the software modules on Midway Games is available by plugging in a portable keyboard. Okay, I'm assuming your game functions will always return 0, 1, or 2. Game over is 0. So hit enter to save and run. But enter just makes it... Set it to 3. Nothing happens. Check the paper attached to the machine. Add the word super. Enter the Chromeister Arcade game serial as the parameter. If the upgrade function was called ping and the serial number was UB4700, the new function name would be super ping and UB4700 would be the parameter. So what was the upgrade? Fight the power. Just super? Oh, that worked. Barnacle Blast. 3? Or is that then the UB numbers? I need the serial number, yeah. So we need to find... Oh! KM5200. KM5200.
This takes an employee access card.
Super KM5200. Did that do something? It did! This music makes me feel very smart.
You're about to play Barnacle Blast. Looks like you have 3 fun credits left on your card. Now, blast all those nasty barnacles off the ship!
Whoa. Okay. Space and arrow keys? Okay. Use the paddle at the bottom of the screen to shoot the ball at the barnacles. Every time you blast the barnacle, your score increases. To control the paddle, use your keyboard. You can control the angle of the ball's bounce with the paddle. Try hitting the ball with different areas of the paddle to change the angle. Okay. Faster you blast all the barnacles, the higher your score. Okay, each time the ball drops to the bottom of the screen, you get another one. If you haven't blasted all the barnacles after 3, the game is over. If you blast all the barnacles in level 1, you'll earn a seashell token. Go on to level 2. Blast all the barnacles in level 2, get a mermaid token. Okay, so I need to clear 2 levels. Go there. Oh god. Yes, I'm a pro. It's very sensitive. Ooh. Do I have a time limit? Oh, I do. No, I don't. Get it! Oh. Get it! Oh, so close. Yes. Get it! Oh, yes. One left. Hell yeah! Okay, get ready for level 2. Ah! Okay, I got this. Yeah, get in there! Ooh, baby! Nice. Oh! So close. Nice! Right side, or left side clear. Go up there! Oh, too bad. Yes, get up there. Yeah! Nice. Pro moves? Pro moves? Pro moves! Just one. Just one. Get it. Oh, fuck. Get it. Ah! So close. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yes. I will take my tokens. Thank you very much. So, what do we get with these? The harmonica? Do we want the shark or the boat? This is the hardest one to get, I think. I don't know what I would need it for, but... Made in Thailand. I don't know why we want the shark or the boat, but we could play another game. I just got that one because that seemed the hardest one to get for the 3 tokens. Shark is the coolest thing. Plays a little ditty. Oh, look at that. It's only A to G. It's important later. Good, then we have it. Maybe we should go back to the hotel for a sec. Just so we can check here. Find the key to that hidden door by the radiator. Ask around about the device under the carousel. See if anyone knows the answer to Miles' first riddle. Oh, I can't go down any faster. Take a look around Ingrid's while she's not there. Translate the note I found in Joy's office. Figure out the combination to Harlan's locker. Keep checking email. Oh, check email. Sassy detective tip 57. Next time you want to hide a message in plain sight, write it on a piece of paper using nature's invisible ink, lemon juice. When you finish writing, You'll have what looks like a blank piece of paper, which to the observant note may smell faintly like lemon. But when you expose the paper to moderate heat, the message will appear. Moderate heat. Just take care when applying heat to the paper and iron. Ah, an iron. On its very lowest setting will usually do the trick. Younger sleuths should seek parental supervision before using an iron. And sleuths of all ages should remember to turn the iron off when finished. Okay. Yesterday after you left, Togo was playing with his yellow squeaky toy in the family room and it rolled underneath the TV cabinet. I tried to get it out with the yardstick, but I couldn't reach it. Now all Togo does is lie there in the family room and whimper. He won't even eat. As you know, that toy was his favorite. But don't worry, I'm going to go to the pet store as soon as it opens and get him a new one. Cute. Okay. Oh, whoops. I need to leave this, I think. So, okay. So we know we can go back to the hotel and read a secret message. Oh, he's not here. Where'd he go? I see you, surveillance. Concealed wall plug transmitters, counter surveillance. Harlan Bishop. Okay. Do you think that's important? Why would we want to look at this? Just take a picture of it. Please keep all personal belongings in your lockers. Oh, yeah. Oh, maybe that's his,
The phone number for the police. That might come in handy.
Maybe his locker code is, that subscription code that we just saw. Wait. Oh, there. Appointments.
Louis G. Wonder who that is. Best way to find out is to call him.
Call an AM to confirm. 2-for-1 Bonanza Burger. He got his priorities straight. Can you imagine putting that stuff in your calendar? Being like, that day I can get a discount on food. Ooh, features.
I wonder what's on here. I'll just play it and find out.
Okay, close it.
I need a tape.
Okay. Who's that? Ingrid? Oh.
It looks like Harlan's been spying on Ingrid.
0726.
I better put this back where I found it.
0726. All good? No one was here. Let's go back to Ingrid.
It's locked.
Not for us. Oh, Nancy.
Call LH about results. LH. Lance Huffington, maybe?
The dude who sprained his neck in the roller coaster? Maybe they worked together so they could get the park closed. There was something else she didn't want me touching on her desk. Ooh, fancy watch. She's spending. Do you think she'll tell us that the...
Wow, that's one expensive watch.
$20,000? For a watch? Paid in cash. Oh, that's so suspicious. She's taking bribes. I think she's taking bribes. In cash? Maybe she's working with the dude with the neck thing. So that they could get the park closed. And then she took a bribe for it. Where did everyone go? Why are both Ingrid and the dude not there? He's here.
Nancy, you're a procrastinator's dream, know that? Come in, ask me questions. Ask me lots of questions.
I found this strange hidden door in the haunted house. Problem is, it's locked. Do you have any idea what's behind it?
Ask Joy. That nutty professor father of hers always had these little secret projects going in the park, even after he sold his interest. Miss Santos didn't have the heart to boot him out.
Hmm.
I know you're busy, but I was hoping you could maybe help me solve a riddle. If I asked you for the silvery remains of a four-bit day, what would you give me?
A riddle? I love riddles. Okay, let's see. Silvery remains has to be something silver that's left over, right? Okay, now, if 2-bit means worth a quarter, 4-bit would mean worth 2 quarters. Quarters. Captain's quarters, maybe?
He's smart.
The hotel adjacent to the park?
Captain's quarters day. Day, spelled D-A-E, as in Sunday. That's it. There's this fantastic Sunday you can get only at the hotel. They call it a fun day. It's been their specialty for like centuries. Comes with a souvenir spoon. Silvery, as in spoon, get it?
Elliot, you're a genius.
Next riddle, come on. I'm on a roll, baby. I'm in a groove. Bring it on.
I'll let you get back to work.
Keep it real.
Keep it real. There it is. Fight the power. Okay, wow, he solved it. Can we order it? Do you think we can get room service? Captain Cove's Fun Day. Chocolate chip brownie layered with ice cream, banana chunks, nuts, whipped cream, and topped with triple thick hot fudge. Oh, sounds amazing.
Hotel operator, what do you want?
Are you the regular operator?
I'm filling in for my cousin Amber. She took the week off on account of the amusement park.
Took the week off!
You don't want an outside line, do you?
Actually, I have a cell phone.
Good, use it. An outside line will cost you an arm and a leg. Besides, I'm not sure how to get you one. So, Ms. Arin, what do you want?
That's Drew. Nancy Drew?
Sorry, my cousin's handwriting reeks. So, what do you want, Ms. Drew?
I'd like to order a fun day.
I'd like to order a fun day, please.
2,480 calories worth of sheer heaven plus one official fun day.
2,480?
Right up. Anything else?
That's it. Thanks
Holy
a lot.
Holy shit. 2,480 calories. Well, oh, that's quick. Wow. Thank you.
Oh, that was so good.
So now the spoon. Captain's Cove. We got the spoon. We did it. Oh, this is exciting. This is like a treasure hunt. Okay, let's go back out. Let's talk to Joy for another riddle.
Any luck? I'm pretty sure Miles wants us to bring him the souvenir spoon you get when you order a fun day Sunday at the captain's quarters. I have one right here.
Give it to Miles and see what happens.
Lay it on me.
Lay it on me. Don't microwave it.
The scan is complete. The object is correct. Your mother used to take you for a Sunday
at the captain's quarters
almost every week. Do you remember, Joy?
The captain's quarters fun day. I do remember that. I was so small, I always had to sit on my mother's lap to eat it. I wish I could remember what she looked like.
Don't you have a picture of her?
You were very little when your mother died, Joy. Your grief came out as anger.
Before your father could stop you,
you destroyed every picture of your mother that he had.
Oh my God.
I did that? No, my father told me he had gotten rid of them. He always said some things are better left forgotten. Oh my gosh. I'm the reason I have nothing to remember her by.
Hmm.
I'm sure your father helped you shut out the truth in order to spare your feelings.
The older your father got, Joy, the more he realized that life is nothing but memories. He realized that even bad memories have a place in a good life. That is why he invented
Miles the Magnificent Memory Machine.
Here is the second riddle. This one is written down. Please remove it.
It's just a blank piece of paper.
You and your mother used to love to play this game, Joy.
I need to go back to the hotel
Once
and
again,
iron it.
I have no idea what he's talking about.
You know, some of the things your father wants you to remember may be pretty painful. Are you sure you want to go on?
If you still want to help me, please, Nancy, keep going. I feel like a door somewhere is starting to creak open. I'm kind of scared to open it, but I also kind of know I have to.
I'll get back to you as soon as I can.
You're the greatest.
This is so cool. Okay, let's go back to the hotel. Here. Secret message. One more time.
The first 8 notes of your favorite band organ tune plus 1 mouth organ plus 1 smidgen of talent equals 1 happy miles.
Okay, so now we just have to learn the tune.
I need to turn the iron on.
No, you don't. I need to leave. Okay. Should we try and talk to her again?
Any luck?
There was a message written in lemon juice on that piece of paper Miles gave us. We're to play the first 8 notes of your favorite band organ tune on a mouth organ for Miles.
My favorite band organ tune? I don't even know what a band organ is. Or a mouth organ either, for that matter.
I think a mouth organ is a harmonica.
Correct. The music you hear when you ride the Captain's Cove carousel comes from the band organ that sits inside the rider.
So now we're gonna have to fix that.
You used to play the harmonica for your mother all the time, Joy. Your favorite tune was the one you heard on the carousel.
It couldn't have been. I never rode the carousel. I always thought it was stupid. I thought all the rides in the park were stupid.
Is that all you can tell us, Miles?
I have been programmed to give you one hint. The tune is on the third roll. You will have to think about this one.
Think about this one? Oh, I got you. I got you, bro.
It's all yours, Detective. As usual, I'm stumped.
I'll get back to you as soon as I can.
Thanks, Nancy.
I'm picking up what he's putting down.
It would be rude to use my phone now.
I really do need to get this working.
Sorry, I didn't mean to click on you. Bye. Where is he? Or she, I actually don't know. Don't remember.
Yeah, this is Tink.
Yes, hello. My name is
Nancy
Drew.
This is Tink.
I never heard of you.
Yes, I know. I'm trying to help Ms. Santos figure out what caused the roller coaster accident that shut down Captain's Cove.
So why are you calling me? I run the carousel. I don't know from coasters.
Well, to make a long story short, I need to find out the name of the band organ song that's on the third roll.
What for?
That's kind of where the long story part comes in.
I haven't got time for long stories. Besides, how do I know you even know Ms. Santos?
To get your number, oh yeah.
Okay, to get your number, I had to get the band organ open, right? And to get the band organ open, I had to have an access card. And to get an access card...
You'd have to know Ms. Santos. Yeah, I get your point. Problem is, I got no idea what song's on the third roll. Only way you're gonna find out is to play it.
Does a band organ still play paper rolls?
You bet. Just flip the switch from CD to roll. Of course, you're gonna need roll 3, ain't you? It's in the cabinet in the gear room.
Gear room?
You mean the one that's locked?
18, 9, 39. That's a combination. Oh, and one more thing. You're gonna have a problem when you go to load the roll on account of... Holy moly! I either snagged a greyhound bus or the biggest fish in the Chaplow River is right here at the end of my line! I'm sorry, hon, I gotta go!
Funny. Okay, so... They're being held somewhere? Is it in here? There's a cabinet here.
Hey, Nancy, what's up?
I found an old letter in the gear room of the carousel. It was written by the guy who carved all the horses, Rolf Kessler. Is it okay if I keep it?
Far as I'm concerned, I'll mention it to Miss Santos, see what she says.
That's interesting. The fact that he's not desperate to get the letter makes me think that maybe he's not after the treasure.
I found some kind of electronic device under the carousel. I'm pretty sure someone has been turning the carousel on and off at night by remote control.
Why would somebody want to do that? Whatever you found was probably just some kind of toy that fell out of some kid's pocket.
Kessler used to have a workshop under what's now the haunted house. Have you ever been down there?
I didn't even know there was a down there there.
So you don't know anything about the hidden door in the room that has the old radiator in it?
Sure don't. Never heard any of the other guards say anything about it either.
May I see that tape of the carousel haunting again?
I got the tape right here, all queued up.
Oh my god, I swear I'm not doing it on purpose. I just click through, I just like exhaust every option, and then I click it and it's too late. Where would those rolls be though? Let me see, let me check here again.
This looks a little like the inside of my aunt's player piano.
Oh.
I wonder what goes on this spool.
Oh, the roll goes on there? Roll. Okay. But first we need to find one. Legend says if you watch the tape 10 more times, something appears. Yeah. Cabinet is on the other side there. You mean it's in here? Oh, this? Ah! Okay, one. How do I roll it? There. One.
Let's see. Miles said the song is on the third roll. This must be it.
Okay. Anything else? No. Let's get that open.
The take-up dowel is broken.
Shit. How do I fix that? Maybe the procrastinator dude? Elliot?
All right, break time.
I need to make a dowel to replace this broken one from the band organ. Would it be all
God,
right?
God, the
if
writing
I
is always
equipment?
So smart.
I won't make a mess, I promise.
Sure. Got a lathe, wooden rod, safety goggles. Knock yourself out. I gotta go run an errand though, so try not to cut off any appendages until I get back.
All right, break time.
A lathe.
How do we work one? Oh, we need to put the goggles on?
It's all fun and games until somebody loses an eye. To carve a new dowel, I'm going to need a piece of wood. To carve a new dowel, I'm going to need a piece of wood.
Oh, a new piece of wood. That we don't have.
Better leave these goggles here.
Do they have? Ooh, what's that? We asked the renowned Weiss siblings, Adam and Charlotte, how much their famous antique violin collection is worth. Professor Anton Sukov, antique carousel expert, talks about the controversy behind the renowned horse carver Rolf Kessler.
If Elliot wrote this guy's number down, maybe I should too.
Okay. Don't just get a horse, get a Kessler. An expert on antique carousels shares his opinion on the work of a controversial horse carver. Article by Anton Sukov, professor of modern American art. For many fanciers of Philadelphia-style carousel horses, adding one of the wonderfully realistic creation of DC Muller and Bro Company to their herd is as good as it gets. But I'm convinced that this is because so few collectors are familiar with the work of Rolf Kessler, surely the golden age of carousel's most underrated carver. Born in Austria in 1882, Kessler was a small man who always felt more at home with animals than he did with people. He He moved to the United States when he was 21 in hopes of riding racehorses. Unfortunately, his reclusive nature and poor social skills undermined any talent he had as a jockey. Out of desperation, he began carving furniture out of wood scraps and selling it on street corners. In 1907, Kessler got an apprenticeship at the Philadelphia Toboggan Company, a top producer of carousels which employed many fine woodcarvers. He lasted a day and a half, but amazingly, using what he had learned at PTC, within a month he had carved a carousel horse in his father-in-law's garage. Within a year, he had used the horse to convince the mayor of Zamboni, New York, that the tiny coastal town, uncanny talent horse carving no doubt came from his lost dream of riding racehorses, should pay him to create a carousel. From 1910 to 1920, Kessler carved horses for four more carousels, two in New Jersey, one in Pennsylvania, and one in Connecticut. In at least two instances, he agreed to lower his price in return for being given his own private on-site workshop. His carousels always had two rows, which included 30 horses and one chariot. But in 1921, his severe mood swings and his angry insistence that the horses he carved existed as living creatures in a parallel dimension had finally driven his wife Amelia away for good. When he realized she was never coming back, he put down his carving tools and went looking for her. It took him 2 years to find her. She died of tuberculosis soon afterwards. No one knows what became of Kessler after that. Homeless, friendless, and now passionless, he simply vanished from history. Kessler is all too often dismissed as a lunatic, a mere poser undeserving of respect because what made his work distinctive was in all probability the result of a chemical imbalance rather than true genius. This is not fair. No one can gaze into the painfully expressive eyes of one of Kessler's horses or study the peaceful delicacy of his trademark black rose and come away unmoved. They are works of art. To treat them as anything less or say more about it and our blind allegiance to conventional artists than it says about them. Though the phase of blue may differ, a black rose can be found on every horse that Kessler carved. Oh, so that's like his trademark. So that's how we know it's an original. After marrying Rolf in 1909, Amelia said that it was impossible for her not to love him as it was for her to live with him. That was it. I'm assuming we'll have the name in our phone. Oh, here, wood. Can we use this? Why would we want to do this? Maybe to dry something? Music is very exciting.
Those look like horse tails.
Who is it shipped to? Wait.
I can use this to measure.
What do you need to measure? So 14 inches, I think. Do we need a pencil? No.
A book on carousels. Cool. Cool.
Famous carousel carvers. The golden age of carousels began in the late 1800s and ended in the early 1930s with the Great Depression. During that period, three different carousel styles emerged. To the trained eye, these styles are as distinct as a fingerprint. Coney Island. The horses that Charles I.D. Loof carved tended to be very fanciful with flashy, often jewel-encrusted saddles and bridles. M.C. Aliens? And Charles Carmel also carved horses that were less realistic, frozen in highly animated poses. Stein and Goldstein carousel horses were known for their big buckles and lack of forelocks. Fantastic factoid. The horse on the outside just in front of the chariot on a carousel is called the lead horse. This horse is usually the biggest and most exquisitely carved horse on the carousel. Fantastic Factoid 2. Some carvers carved only the heads and let other craftsmen carve the rest of the horse. Philadelphia style. These carousel horses were very realistic, with many sporting armor and other militaristic gear. Carousels that the Denzel Company built often included horses with human faces carved somewhere on their sides. The Philadelphia Toboggan Company was not founded by carvers. As a result, its carousels displayed many variations of the Philadelphia style. Most horses that are mounted on permanent carousels have tails made of real horsehair. A carousel horse was carved out of many pieces of wood that were held together with glue and small dowels, never nails because they would rust. A horse's leg could be made out of as many as 6 pieces of wood. Daniel and Alfred Muller of the DC Muller & Bro Company were famous for their exceptionally intricate and realistic carousel figures. One of the company's founders, Daniel Muller, is often said to be the best carver of carousel horses ever. Those familiar with Rolf Kessler's work might disagree. Driven by dark moods and odd convictions, Kessler worked by himself, creating carousels on a freelance basis. Some people found the intense expressions of Kessler's creations to be a little too realistic. County fair style. A number of companies specialized in carousels that could be effortlessly moved from one place to another. Carousel horses they created were relatively simple in appearance so that they could be produced quickly and moved with minimal breakage. Armitage, Herschel, and Spillman were known for this style, and the carousels of the Sea Wee Parker Amusement Company were seen throughout the American heartland in the early 1900s. Horses were carved out of soft hardwood, like basswood. This wood is soft enough to carve easily but hard enough to stand up to a lot of wear. The side of the horse that faced out and was most seen by the public was called its romance side. Since it was the most visible side, it usually included much more detail than the inner side. I never thought about that. That's probably an actual thing. Carousels or merry-go-rounds evolved from games people in the Middle Ages used to play on horseback. In the 12th century, the Spanish named one of these games Carusela, which means little war. Okay. By the 17th century, carousel among the French royalty meant a festive day of contests on horseback. In one of these contests, riders would try to spear a small ring with their lance while galloping past it at full speed. Oh. To practice for this event, noblemen would straddle a wooden horse that hung from an arm that was attached to a center pole. Oh. As this center pole and arm turned, powered by horse, mule, or servant, the rider would try and spear a small stationary ring mounted on the outside of a machine. Eventually, the word carousel referred to this machine rather than the pageant. Pageant? On horseback that inspired it. By the mid-1800s, men, women, and children of all social classes were clamoring to ride the contraption, which by this time included several rows of wooden horses. Innovations occurred rapidly after the carousel became... Oh, it's a BB! Early 20th century riders rode the carousel for the cool breeze it generated and for the thrill of riding something going fast. 7 miles per hour. Hey, Pete. You want to come here? Carousel horses were often named. Their names would appear on the inside of the bridles. Yeah, we've seen that. Steam driven in 1870. By the early 1900s, the carousel looked pretty much the way it does today. It is interesting to note that English carousels rotated clockwise, while carousels in America and the rest of Europe rotated in the counterclockwise direction. This is because the English thought it was important that riders be encouraged to mount from the proper side, the horse's left side. Also, the game of trying to grab the brass ring was never popular in England. In the United States, moving counterclockwise allowed the carousel riders to use their right hands to reach for the rings as they went by. Interesting. And what is also interesting is that I have a BB. Menagerie figures such as tigers, dogs, giraffes, and even frogs were found alongside horses on carousels in the late 19th century. But by 1920, these figures were on their way out because the carousel makers realized that many children were frightened of them and preferred to ride horses. The horses on the outside are bigger and more ornate than the horses on the inside, so they can be seen from a distance and will attract potential customers. Oh my god, it just keeps going. I don't know if I've ever read this much in Nancy from one book. What is a band organ? In 1920, most carousels in the United States were treating their customers not just to a cool, refreshing breeze as they rode, but to the bright, lively sounds of that distinctly American invention known as the band organ. The band organ is a mechanical device, meaning that someone doesn't have to play it. Rather, it produces music by mechanical means. In very simple terms, air supplied by a bellows at the bottom of the organ is forced through pipes which produce musical notes in relation to holes punched in a roll of paper. Yeah. A variety of pipes can be activated at one time along drums and cymbals so that the music... I didn't know that was like an American thing. We have them in the Netherlands too. I thought they were Dutch. Many people think the music they hear when they ride a carousel is calliope music. Calliope, however, is a totally different machine. Designed to attract attention, the high-pitched flute-like calliope tones are usually heard at the circus. Some antique band organs house speakers to simply broadcast pre-recorded music. Aw, man! But some still use the traditional but fragile paper rolls, while in others, the pipes are activated according to digital recorded patterns. Some band organs can go back and forth between the old ways of playing tunes and the new, improving the likelihood that as long as there are carousels, there will be band organ music. Okay, that was it. Ugh, that was a lot of reading. Very interesting, though. I like it. Maybe something in this corner. Do we get wood here? Ah! Maybe now I can do it? It's set to 14 already. That's good, right? Oh, can't go further? Nope. How do we change that? Measure the notches first. We did, and it was, oh. And then he left. It was 14.
Better leave these goggles here.
Because, oh, do we need the whole thing, right? Otherwise she wouldn't put it there. So it's 14. Measure the indents. Recreate the way it looks. Oh, so like 2.5 inches, then go inward. And then stop at 11.1. Okay, I can do that. So, wait, how do I fine-tune it, though? We can only do 2 or 3. 3 to 11 is probably fine. So it's 3 settings. Let's try this. Oh. Is that correct, you think? Oh, oops. Oh, so that's how wide it cuts. As well. Oh. Set it to 3 in deepest cut. Isn't 3 also the deepest cut? I can only do this. Oh, you mean from there? Oh, okay.
That
I see what you mean.
Look right.
Yeah, you think? So, move it to here. And then it's from 2.5. Perfect. Okay. So, wait, let me, so the edge of it was 11.1. Should I try it? Yeah, like that. So that's good. Yeah. Okay, so that's that part. And then there's also an indentation here on the site, right? On 12? Yeah. A very small one. Like that, maybe?
That looks perfect.
Oh. Thanks.
Better leave these goggles here.
I did it. Okay. Now let's go back to the carousel. See if we can get it to work. Cards, please. Okay, great. How does she know how to do this? Set to roll. Oh, I know what to do.
I need to tape them to the pipes.
So then we can see which one's activated. But I need tape. Maybe at Ingrid's?
It's locked.
Not for me, it isn't. No tape here. Oh yeah, we haven't called the number either. LH. G. Lewis. Who's that? I don't think we've called that before.
Talk to me.
Yes, hi. Is this Lance Huffington?
You betcha. Who's this?
Well, I'm Nancy Drew. I work with Ingrid Corey. I'm kind of her unofficial assistant here at the park. She tells me everything.
Oh, yeah?
Oh. Yeah, I was wondering if she'd called you yet. You know, about the results.
Yeah, she called me.
So, is everything okay?
Everything's great. Her plan worked. I'm glad she shared it with me. Life's good. At least it will be when the trial's over and the settlement's in the bank.
Oh,
speaking of which, I gotta go. I'm due in court. What'd you say your name was?
Nancy.
Well, Nancy, next time you call me, you could very well be talking to a multimillionaire. Ta-ta.
Bye.
We caught them in the act. And this is the one from the magazine?
Sukov.
My name is Nancy
Sukov.
Drew. I saw the article you wrote about Rolf Kessler in the Collector's Hot Sheet magazine.
That was several months back, but go on.
Well, seeing as you're pretty much an expert on Kessler as well as carousels, I wondered if you could answer a question or two for me.
I'd be delighted.
I would be delighted.
Did you by any chance hear about the horse that was stolen off the carousel at Captain's Cove Amusement Park in New Jersey? It was one of the carousels that Kessler carved.
Yes, I did. And I thought, how odd. Because, you see, I'd gotten a call from someone about a month prior to that asking me how much I thought one of those horses would be worth.
Really? Do you have any idea who it was that called?
None whatsoever. He never gave me his name, nor did he say where he was calling from. The thought that I may have actually encouraged someone to mutilate a work of art. Oh.
How much would a horse from a Kessler carousel be worth?
Depending on its condition, whether it's an inside horse or an outside horse, whether it's the lead horse, anywhere from $80,000 to well over $100,000.
Wow, that's
Damn.
A lot of money.
Yes, it is. But Kessler carved horses for only 5 carousels in his lifetime. So not only is each horse exquisitely beautiful, but it's very rare, especially if it's the lead horse.
The lead horse?
The outside horse, just behind the chariot. The place where you can sit instead of ride. It's traditionally the most ornately carved horse on the carousel, hence the most valuable.
Did you hear about how the carousel at Captain's Cove is now allegedly haunted because one of the horses was stolen?
Yes, what a wonderfully romantic piece of nonsense.
Do you have any idea why someone would be going to the trouble of making the carousel turn on and off by itself?
As a matter of fact, I do. I think that someone wants publicity. Whoever stole the horse wants people to know that it's gone so that when he or she goes to sell it, there will be a whole slew of eager buyers.
But we're talking about stolen property. Are you saying people would willingly buy something they know was stolen?
Yes, they would.
We're talking about the black market, my dear. Great works of art get stolen by thieves and bought by less than scrupulous collectors all the time.
If someone did steal that horse off the carousel in order to make money off of it, what would be his or her next move? How would they go about selling it?
Well, the thief would probably get a middleman to set up a bidding war between several buyers in order to get the highest price. The internet comes in very handy in such matters.
Thanks for all the info.
Call again anytime.
Middleman, like the dude, LH. Actually, I think they're just trying to get money from the company. I don't think they're actually trying to get the treasure that's out of, in the horse. Maybe. Call Louis J. G. Gee, Louis, I don't know.
State Board of Parole, Louis Guerra's office.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
I said State Board of Parole, Luis Guerra's office.
Is Mr. Guerra a parole officer?
That's correct, but he's out of the office right now. Would you like to leave a message?
Yes, please. Would you have him call Nancy Drew?
Concerning?
Harlan Bishop. I believe he's a client of Mr. Guerra's.
Is Harlan up to something he shouldn't be?
I'm not sure yet. Would you happen to know what prison he was in?
You're going to have to wait and ask Mr. Guerra that question.
So he's an
what
ex.
What was the name?
Nancy
prisoner.
Drew, my number is 523-555-4399. That's my cell phone. He can call me anytime.
I'll let him know.
Thank you.
Interesting. So he could possibly be the inmate that was with the dude who stole all the stuff in the past and hid it somewhere. Let's go back to the... Oh,
hello.
Hi, it's Paula. Just thought I'd check in, see how you're doing.
Actually, I'm kind of glad you called.
Why? What's going on?
I'm afraid I've discovered something kind of disturbing about Harlan.
What, that he's an ex-con? I know.
You do?
It was the first thing out of his mouth when he applied for the job.
That's honest.
He said being an outstanding security guard would prove to everyone once and for all that he's gone straight.
I also found out that he used a security camera to get the code to Ingrid's work area. And he fits the description of the jewel thief's cellmate that Detective Paris gave me.
Oh, now that's disturbing. But I'm still going to give Harlan the benefit of the doubt until I have good reason not to.
That's good.
I appreciate your bringing this to my attention, though.
All right. Goodbye, Paula.
You should definitely give someone a second chance. Maybe he's a good guy. Now. Determine what the plan is that Ingrid shared with Lance Hoffington. I mean, obviously. He wasn't actually in pain. Ask around about the device I found under the carousel. Translate the note I found in Joy's office. Keep checking email. More news. I went to every single pet store in River Heights and wouldn't, you know, not one of them carries yellow squeaky toys. Togo hasn't budged that from in front of the TV cabinet. He still refuses to eat and I'm getting worried. You know how I fret when you're... when you Jews don't eat. So I called your father and he arranged for two men to come over later on today, unplug all those cables and wires, and move the cabinet. He wasn't really happy about it, but I told him it's what you want. Next time you find a bad guy closing in on you, remember that you can often escape by distracting him. Direct his attention to something valuable that you have, your watch, wallet, purse, even your weapon. Then toss it aside, or if the situation warrants, toss it at you, your would-be assailant. A moment of or two of distraction is usually all the mentally and physically agile detective needs to make a successful escape. Huh. Well, basically said just keep talking to people. We need tape. Maybe there's tape in Joy's office.
Oh, hello?
This is Luis Guerra with the State Board of Parole. I understand you have some questions concerning Harlan Bishop.
Right. Hi. Yes, for starters, could you tell me what prison he was in?
He served 30 months in Bayside State Prison for check kiting and forgery. He was paroled 5 weeks
check
ago.
Check kiting? What's that?
Did you say Bayside State Prison?
Yes, I did.
To your knowledge, has he ever gone by any other name besides Harlan Bishop?
No, ma'am.
Advice for mugging?
Have you seen him since he's been paroled?
He comes to my office once a week. As far as I know, Harlan is a security guard at Captain's Cove Amusement Park. Now, do all these questions mean you know something about him that I don't?
Actually, maybe I do.
Oh? What?
You failed to mention that he's one of the nicest guys you'd ever want to meet.
Very true. Well, I hope I've been of some assistance.
Oh, you have. You've been a big help. Thank you.
Good day, then.
Bye. Form of check fraud. Ah, involving taking advantage of the float to make use of non-existent funds. Wow. Instead of being used as a negotiable instrument, checks are misused as a form of unauthorized credit. Okay. Interesting.
Any luck?
I think we're all set. I know the tune, and I've got a harmonica.
Play it for Miles and see what happens.
My oral sensors are ready. Suck it to me.
Wait, I don't have it yet, do I? I don't know it. I mean, I heard it, but I didn't do the tape thing yet.
Close, but no cigar.
Maybe I should go listen to the tune again and come back later.
We will be waiting.
Okay, do you have any tape on your desk that I can borrow? Doesn't look like it. I hate his robot voice.
Hey, Beth, it's Nancy.
Oh, hey, Nancy.
Whoa, you were obviously hoping I was someone else.
Well, kinda.
Okay, so who is he and where'd you meet him?
Oh, Nancy, his name's Matt, and he is so cute. He works the concession stand at the movie theater in the mall. A cute guy with an endless supply of gummy bears and butter flavoring. Right at his fingertips. We're talking major crush.
Hey, George, good. You're there, too.
Barely. I almost got caught standing between Bess and the phone just now. When it rings, she's like a one-woman cattle stampede.
What happened to caller ID, Bess?
My parents yanked it. She wouldn't pick up when it was some loser she didn't want to talk to. Her mother got tired of hearing the phone ring all the time. Not all those calls were from losers. Sometimes I was playing hard to get. Anyway, how are things at the amusement park?
I met the security guard, Harlan Bishop. Nice guy. Except when I asked him where he worked before. He seemed kind of evasive.
Is he cute? Bess, what difference does that make? Ugly people have chips on their shoulders and are more likely to commit crimes, George. I read that somewhere. Either read it or saw it on Oprah.
Okay.
He's from New Jersey. I'm pretty sure about that.
Well, I guess that's not surprising. But if he was evasive, we know what that means, don't we, Bess? Suspect list.
I think I might know why somebody stole that horse off the carousel. They were looking for jewels that had been hidden inside it after a hotel robbery.
Hidden jewels? I love it! That's almost as good as buried treasure! But if they recovered the jewels, why is the carousel still going around by itself?
I'm not sure yet, but the detective who is in charge of investigating the robbery is helping me look into it.
Don't let George discourage you, Nancy. I, for one, think you're on the right track. You can never go wrong when jewelry is involved.
There was a brochure for a sports car in Ingrid's work area, the Pandora 2XS.
That is like the hottest car ever. One of the most expensive, that's for sure. She must make a ton of money.
Either that or she's about to come into a ton of money.
The engine oil thickens.
It's kind of funny that someone who uses the aura card on people, like in karma, has a plan to bribe people and take the money.
I need you guys to do something for me. I found some stenography notes that I'd really like to translate, only I don't know shorthand.
Say no more. We'll do some research and get right back to you.
We will? I barely know how to spell stenography, let alone research it.
We'll call you when we're through. We can do this, Bess.
What is with all this wee stuff?
I finally met the park's art director, Elliot Chen. We kind of got off on the wrong foot, but he's real friendly to me now.
But is he too friendly? That's the question.
Yeah. Maybe he's trying to deflect suspicion by making nice.
That could be. I do get the feeling he knows more about the carousel than he lets on.
Uh-oh. Sounds like another candidate for the suspect list.
I found out that after Joy's mother died, she was so distraught that she destroyed every single picture of her mother that her father had.
Yikes. That's a little twisted.
The really weird thing is that she'd completely blocked it out of her memory. She thought her father had destroyed all the pictures.
Sounds like she could use a good shrink.
I'd leave her on your suspect list. That's for sure.
I almost got creamed by the roller coaster when I was on the tracks looking around, and I don't think it was an accident.
Someone tried to kill you? Ouch.
I found one of Joy's chewed-up pencils just before it happened, but she says she doesn't know how it got there.
Just from now on, stay away from that coaster, Nan. Stick to the carousel. Man, I never thought I'd hear myself say that.
Got anything for me in the way of hints?
In order to play that carousel tune for Miles, you're either going to have to memorize it or figure out what pipes are playing the melody and write down the notes.
I think you ought to call you-know-who.
You're exceptionally cute today. You know that, George?
Catch you guys later.
We'll be right here. Toodles.
Toodles.
Hello?
Hey, Frank. It's Nancy.
Hey, Joe. Pick up. Actually, he may not want to talk to you.
Why not?
Because you get to solve a mystery at an amusement park. He's so jealous he could spit.
Hi, this is Joe.
Hey, Joe, it's Nancy.
I don't want to talk to you.
What did I tell you?
Oh, I'm just kidding. Pardon me for a second. I gotta go spit.
Quit fooling around, Joe. She's calling long distance, remember?
Sorry. So what's going on?
Apparently, one of the people who was on the roller coaster when it suddenly stopped is claiming that his neck got injured and has filed a lawsuit.
Well, boys and girls, can you say insurance fraud?
What if someone is making up a false claim? What if that was his plan all along? And what if someone in the park is in on the scheme with him?
Mm-hmm. That person causes the accident, the guy sues, they split the settlement.
New word, boys and girls, can you say motive?
Has either of you ever heard of a guy named Rolf Kessler?
Rolf Kessler? The name is kind of familiar. Give me a minute, it'll come to me.
Don't let him fool you, Nance. He's sitting at his computer madly typing Rolf Kessler into a search engine.
Rolf Kessler. Carved carousel horses in the early part of the 20th century. Very eccentric. Said if anyone separated his horses once they were part of a carousel, bad luck would follow.
Let me guess. That's who carved the carousel at Captain's Cove.
You got it. I found a letter that he wrote but never mailed to his estranged wife, Amelia. He was eccentric, all right.
So there might be something to this curse stuff after all.
Frank, I'm shocked. You've always said there is no such thing as curses.
What I mean is, whoever is responsible for these carousel hauntings obviously knew something about Kessler. He's the key, Nan. Kessler's the key.
Any suggestions as to my next move?
Figuring out which pipes play the melody would help you figure out how to reproduce that carousel tune.
Fishing for info would probably help, too.
Yeah, we need to get tape.
Don't take any wooden nickels.
Any what now? The tape
hey,
is
Nance,
here,
what's
but...
going on?
I'll let you get back to work.
Thanks a lot.
We can't grab it. Like, I want it. Oh, maybe if I... No. I was thinking maybe I preemptively could put tape on it, but... There's tape beyond... Oh.
Would it be okay if I took some tape? It might come in handy.
Help yourself.
There is a second roll of tape. I didn't even see that. I was so, like, zoned in on that one tape. I was like, that's tape. That's what I need. That's it. Okay. Open up. Okay, I need to get ready to write. Write the letters. A, E, D, E, F, E. Okay, let me see again. E, D, E, F, E, A, E, D, C, B, A. That's it? A, E, D, E, F, E, A, E, D, C, B, A. Okay, got it.
I better turn this off.
That should do it.
Will Mantro please report immediately to the security office? And by immediately, I mean don't even think about doing anything else.
Excuse me?
I just got off the phone with Miss Santos. Where do you get off telling her I'm some kind of jewel-thieving peeping Tom?
She called you?
Of course she called. She hired me because she thought I deserved a second chance. She wanted to make sure I hadn't betrayed her trust, which I hadn't, by the way.
It's just that when I found out you'd been spying on some of your co-workers...
I wasn't spying on them. I really think that to do my job right, I should be able to go anywhere in the park. You know, in case of emergencies. Okay, so maybe I'm trying a little too hard. Maybe people's entry code should be off limits.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that this job means everything to me. I don't want to screw it up.
I guess I was a little overzealous, too. I'm really sorry. I'll see you around.
Bye. That's it. Joy.
Will Nancy Drew please report to the security office?
Dude, I just came from there.
Hello?
Hi, Nance. We found some stuff in the stenography.
Everyone needs me.
So now it's we, huh? Okay, George found most of it. Surprise, surprise. But I helped.
Thank you so much. You guys are the best.
So go back to the hotel and check your laptop. We emailed a little tutorial to you. But you gotta promise to let us know what the note you translate says.
I promise. Thanks again, you guys.
Okay.
I stepped out for a second, and when I came back, somebody'd left this envelope on my desk. Looks like it's for you. Got your name on it anyway.
Hmm.
There's nothing inside but a key. Maybe it opens that door in the haunted house.
Here, let me toss that envelope for you. I want to apologize for jumping all over you like that before. The more I thought about it, the more I realized that I would have done just what you did. No hard feelings?
No hard feelings.
Who sent me a key? Who knew? What? Who did that? Which one is it? Steno info. Learning shorthand the quick way. Shorthand is a system of writing words quickly using the sounds of words. The word I is written O, which represents the sound I. This method is sometimes called phonetic writing. Following lessons, you'll learn some basic shorthand strokes based on the Gregg method, which was developed in 1888. Okay. Should I write this down? Stenograph stroke for S is a small comma. Stroke is also used for the sound of a Z. The sound for A as in May or day is a small circle. Oh, so there's a small and a big circle? Below is a shorthand for the word say. But some words in stenography are read from top to bottom. Some from left to right. Holy shit, this is so complicated. That is so weird. I've never heard about this. Shorthand for ace is written with an A on top of the S. So ace is a 9, basically. Weird. Shorthand is based on the sound of the word. Letters that are not pronounced are left out. So the word say only includes the strokes for S and A, and it doesn't include Y. The word ace only includes A and S, not an E. Stroke for S is used instead of a C because the word C makes an S sound. Holy shit. I learned the strokes for the S and A sound. We also learned that letters that are not pronounced are not written. Below are words which are short, contain silent letters. Below each word type the letter that is not pronounced and so would not be written. Wait. Main. Well, I guess the A? The E, I mean, A is Dutch. Snow. Perfect score! Shorthand stroke for E is smaller circle than the A one compared to two. Yeah, I wrote that down. This is gonna be difficult. Oh my god. Shorthand for N is very short line. M is twice as long. The K in knee is represented with the N stroke. That's because, yeah, that's how you pronounce it. Knee and me. Wow. I'm actually studying. You know how the strokes for E and N and M? Below are some words using these strokes. Type the correct word in longhand below. So... May? Me? So that's also an E? Wait, but that's what I wrote down. Wait, what is it then? Oh wait, it's the other one. Say. Oh. Sing? But there's no... But there's no... Oh, because the line keeps going? Oh. Oh my god. So this is... Mine? Mean? Wouldn't that be two circles? Wait, how do you know? Could be so many, like, combinations. So this, then, is the big one, so... Nim. Name. Oh my god. Wait, but that would mean the circle is an A as well. How does that work? Oh, was it a tiny one? Wasn't a big circle. Oh my god. Shorthand stroke for O is a very small, deep hook. Stroke for R is a short forward curve, and stroke for L is a longer forward curve. Okay. Little fish hook. Okay, so they become longer each time. So, ray, lay. So is the curve with a little fishhook at the end. Oh, I see it. Ray, so the Y is silent, so R-A. So it's a medium-sized fishhook with an A, small circle. Note that or all is written with a sideways stroke for O. This is done to make the stroke more fluid. Oh. Okay, or seems like an important one, so I'll write that down. So, M, O, more, mole, okay, so this would be an S. Follow it with a... This would be say, or... But with an R or L on the end. Sail? Oh, good one, guys. This would be an N, follow it with an A. Kneel? You guys say this is kneel? How? Oh, because the K is silent. All right. Oh my god. So hard. Anyone who can write this really quickly is a fucking genius. In lesson 3, you learned to stroke for O. The O sound is 2. Ooh. Is represented by a tiny upward hook. Oh. Okay. Rule. Jesus Christ. How does anyone read this? Sounds not letters, yeah. Lou. Double lines under the word for Lou. That means the word should be capitalized. Oh. Capitalization. Rule. So that's the R, the U sound, followed with an L. Oh my god. Okay. The strokes for K and G are similar to the U stroke, but K is twice as large as the U stroke, and the G is twice as large as the K one. Ghoul, glow. Glow? G, L. So big one, big one. And then silent W, small O. You now know the strokes. Uh-huh. Test your knowledge. Okay, so... Glory? I did it! I did it! Holy shit! Okay. Good... Gray? You think gray? A. What's the A sound? Is that the big? Was it the big or small circle? Oh, well, whatever. That was very interesting. So now we need to... Oh, name. They agreed to sell the horse named... Glory. Capital letters. Isn't that Glory? It's Glory.
The name of the carousel horse is Glory.
The horse will be removed from the ride on August 3rd. Oh, other than that, we don't have to do anything? Let me see. Ask around about the device. Keep checking email. Okay. Keep checking email, ask around about the device. Then order a fun day. Determine what the plan is for Ingrid and Lance. Play it for Miles. Oh, I haven't done that yet. Go play the band organ tune for Miles. Let's do that first.
Any luck? I think we're all set. I know the tune and I've got a harmonica. Play it for Miles and see what happens.
My oral sensors are ready. Suck it to me.
Suck it to me. Okay.
Hooray!
I remember that
song.
Oh,
I wasn't done yet.
I did ride the carousel over and over and over. Always the same horse. Always the same black horse.
You love the carousel, and you loved one horse in particular. It was not the lead horse, and it was not spectacular, but you loved it, Joy. What was its name?
Glory.
I can't remember.
Is the name important?
I am not programmed to continue unless and until you remember the name of that horse. You loved it so much that your mother bought it for you.
She was the one who bought the horse off the carousel? Then I know the name. Glory.
Glory. That's right. Mm-hmm. Glory. My mother gave him to me for my birthday. My fourth birthday. She died in a car accident that very night.
Someone killed her to get the horse.
How awful. No wonder you forgot how much you loved the carousel. It would have reminded you of your mother.
I hated the park after my mother died. I hated the carousel. And I hated that horse. I blamed it for what happened to my mother. I had my father destroy it.
Oh, they still got the...
But your father did not destroy it. Instead, he stored it.
Ah.
He hoped that someday...
So someone didn't get to the horse.
Miles, the magnificent memory machine!
You would come to terms with your past.
Where did he store it?
That is what you are doing. Here is the third and final riddle. Ask Tink for the book you and I used to read about Kessler and Amelia so kind. Give her nickname a spin on spook number 10. Then the brass prize arrange on its forearm so strange. And something long lost and cherished you'll find.
Tink's the guy who runs the carousel. Let's give him a call. I've got his number.
No. Nancy, I did something terrible. I turned the power off to the roller coaster and caused the accident that shut down the park. I blamed Miss Santos for my father's death, just like I blamed that horse for what happened to my mother. I feel horrible. Keep going without me, Nancy. I have to go see Miss Santos and apologize.
Oh, interesting. Glory! Now we got that. We still have the key as well. Let's see. We have a random person who gave us the key. Call Tink. Oh yeah. I love how she has like a pencil and like a little notepad and it's like identical
Hi, it's
to
Nancy
mine.
Drew. Did you land that fish?
I don't want to talk about it. That answer your question?
According to the late Daryl Trent, you have a book about Roth Kessler and his wife.
Not anymore, I don't.
You don't have it?
Daryl Trent was kind of an oddball, you know what I mean? So when he gave me the book, I said I'd hang on to it just to humor. As soon as he died, I pitched it.
Damn.
You threw it out? You mean in the
music,
garbage?
Yeah.
He said it was a book he and his kid used to read. But hey, Daryl Trent was dead. I never met the kid and the book was boring. So what was the point?
I need to find out Amelia's nickname.
Who's Amelia?
Oh, never mind.
Sorry.
I'm curious. Who do you think stole that horse off the carousel?
Kids. Staring at each other. Doing stupid kid stuff. Maybe somebody just liked the way old Nightshade looked and wanted him for himself. I don't know.
Nightshade?
That was its name. Nightshade. Kessler gave all of his horses names. Painted them on their bridles.
Uh-huh. Nightshade.
Have fun fishing.
Oh, I will.
So Nightshade was the one that was stolen. Let's see if it works. If it was a hog, that would have been too rusty and we would have gotten oil first.
Maybe these stairs go down to Kessler's workshop.
They should. What's that? Uh-oh.
What was that?
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. It's above you. Oh.
You were unconscious for how long?
I'm not sure. Whatever fell on my head also fell on my arm and broke my watch.
I can't afford any more accidents, Nancy. And since you seem to be rather accident prone, well, let's just say you're off the case.
Hmm. Oh, wait, I can do something?
What was that?
Wait, what it? But it's a cutscene. Oh, I can just back out. Wait, you don't want to check it out? All that for some pliers? Hmm. Who was missing pliers? I don't remember. Ingrid?
Hello, Nancy.
How goes it?
Well, let's just start at the top.
I found something underneath the carousel that looks like it might be a remote control device.
Oh, I'd like to see it. Interesting. I looked under there. Wonder how I missed it. May I have this?
Actually, I'd kind of like to keep it.
Suit yourself.
Did you know that the man who carved the carousel horses had a workshop under what's now the haunted house?
How appropriate, considering Kessler's belief in the supernatural.
She does know, because she was there.
I heard some strange sounds the last time I was in there. They seemed to be coming from below.
That's odd. I've been doing a lot of work in there lately, and I haven't heard any strange noises. So either your ears are better than mine, or your imagination is.
I got your soldering gun from Elliot and fixed that card reader. Does he borrow your tools a lot?
Very rarely. He's not exactly a mechanical genius.
Here's your pliers. I found them in the haunted house behind a hidden door, which led to a booby trap.
I told you mine were missing. Maybe somebody found them and left them by that door on purpose. I don't know. But they prove nothing. I do know that.
I understand that you know the man who got hurt in that roller coaster accident, Lance Huffington?
I've talked to him. I don't really know him.
What did you talk to him about?
Look, what are you getting at?
I was just wondering if maybe you and he are in cahoots.
Are you suggesting that he and I planned the accident? Mm-hmm. He gets on the coaster, I shut off the power, he cries whiplash and gives me half of whatever he gets from the lawsuit? Interesting theory. Unfortunately, it's totally wrong. I called him to tell him to rub his neck 3 times a day with witch hazel and lavender. If his neck is really injured, that will cure it.
God damn it.
Why are you so eager to accuse me of something?
Because you seem to have a lot of money, far more than the park pays you. I can't help but wonder where it's coming from.
All right. I have been making money on the side.
Oh.
But it's not what you think. I've been helping someone design a roller coaster. I even let him borrow the blueprints for our coaster so he could study them, not steal them.
Hmm.
I kept it secret because it could be construed as conflict of interest.
I mean, that's literally what it is.
So he pays me very well.
You can't just go off giving blueprints to the competitor.
Around in here.
What the fuck?
How did you get in?
Well, it seems that one of the security guards has been doing a little extracurricular surveillance work.
Harlan. I knew it bugged him that this place was off limits, but spying on me? That guy's got a real problem. As for you, I'd appreciate it if you would kindly remove your nice and deficient little self from my office. I have work to do.
Always with the niacin. God damn. Huh. So that actually didn't get us anywhere.
Sukov!
Hi, it's Nancy Drew again. I have another question for you about Rolf Kessler. A very important question.
Let's hear it.
Would you happen to know the nickname Rolf Kessler gave his wife, Amelia?
Of course I do. At least, I thought I did. It was an Austrian term of endearment, rather common. Oh, come on, Anton, think. Spatzi! That was it! Spatzi! S-P-A-T-Z-I. He always called her Spatzi.
Okay.
Thanks for all the info.
Glad to help.
Spatzi. So why do we need to know that? So someone wants me to go back here?
It's locked.
Oh, it sounds from below again. I can't check on the dummy for some reason. What should we do? Need to fix the monster, it has a red tag. Oh yeah. That just means it's powered down now, right?
Looks like Spook 10 is missing an arm.
Mm-hmm.
The arm is missing. It's been red tagged. Oops, no power.
That's where we put it in. Can we get the arm from the other guy? We can't. No, he's missing arms too.
Hello, Nancy. How goes it?
There's a dummy in the haunted house that's been red tagged. It's missing an arm. Any chance it'll be up and running again in the near future?
Got the arm right here. Just needed a battery. That's one of the dummies Joy Trent's father created. Probably why the circuitry is so bizarre. It works though, so just reattach it. You'll need pliers. Oh, and don't forget to take the red tag back to Spymaster Bishop.
Thanks for your help.
No big deal.
Oh, she gave me pliers. Okay. I don't like those sounds coming from below. It's so creepy. Do you want the pliers still? That good?
That looks tight enough.
Okay.
Oops, no power.
How do we turn the power on?
I need to take this red tag back
to right.
Harlan.
Harlan. Durr.
Hey, Nancy, what's up?
Could you please turn the juice back on to the dummy in the haunted house that Ingrid was fixing? Here's the tag.
You've really got the system down, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
I'll just flip the switch and you'll be good to go.
I'm not gonna click
See you
it.
Around.
Sounds good.
I'm not gonna click it. I did it! Biggest achievement of today. I didn't click it. I didn't watch the tape. Why is that even an option? Why can't you watch the tape again and again? Close to the end now? Oh. Okay, he's definitely powered. Spatsy. What'd that arm do? Why is the arm like that? Do you want a ring? Oh, Joy, this is it. There was a trapdoor there.
That must be Glory. These stairs sure don't feel very safe.
Oh god. Don't die. I want to go back. Oh.
Oh my gosh.
The jewels.
The jewels from that jewel heist. A letter. Joy's father must have left it for her. My dearest Joy, I hope Miles and his riddles have helped you remember how much you adored this horse. And how dearly you loved the woman who gave it to you. I found this picture of her years ago, but I didn't want to give it to you until I knew you were ready.
Nice.
She loved you more than anything, Joy. We both did, Dad. P.S. If you want to see where Glory was carved, look for Kessler's symbol on the wall. I could never spend a lot of time in there. Very strange vibes.
Strange vibes.
I should probably take these with me.
Not all of them? Okay, there's the symbol. The rose.
So this was Kessler's workshop.
Wow. That's all here preserved?
Nightshade!
Wait, but if it was stolen, how is it down here? So someone knew about this workshop and just stashed it here?
Somebody's been making reproductions. Or should I say forgeries?
Oh. Oh, so they're planning to like just sell five forgeries like on the black market and make more and more money. Dark Horse and Hunter or Huckster. Already have two potential buyers. They learned about the hauntings on TV and are champing at the bit. As it were, the sooner they can get the horse, the better. How soon can you get two done? A 40-60 split will work out great. Consider this a handshake. How long will you line up the buyers? 3 to 5 weeks is too long. This kind of buyer gets cold feet real fast. The longer you take, the more suspicious they'll get. Work faster. That's true. It's taking me longer than I thought it would. Won't have the first horse ready to ship for 3 weeks. The second horse will be ready in maybe five. Okay. Well, it must be Elliot then, right? Because he would procrastinate all the time. And he had a box of horsehair in his workshop. Is there anything else you can look at? No. There
Nancy,
he is!
Nancy, Nancy, what have you done?
It's what you've done. You stole the horse, you fabricated the whole haunted carousel thing to increase its value, and now you're making not just one forgery, but several.
You think?
You let everyone believe you were just a hopeless procrastinator. But this is the real reason you're behind in your work, isn't it?
Right on all counts. Unfortunately, you're not gonna get to tell anyone else. Ever.
No, wait. Look what I have. They're diamonds. Real diamonds. Someone stole them 23 years ago and stashed them in the park.
Well, well, a little icing on the cake.
Oh, right. You could distract them by throwing them, right? That's what the hint told us.
That's right. You want them? Here.
Ouch!
Hey. Right in the face! Watch out for the staircase, though. Oh. We're actually out. Oh.
I'm trapped. I've got to get out of here.
Can you write
the... Nancy. You're cornered.
Is he going to fall in?
You might as well give up.
He's going to fall in. He's going to fall in. Oh, no. He went over. What do I have on me? I don't know what to do. Call him on 911.
It would be rude to use my phone now.
Really? I don't think so. You want to throw more? Oh.
End of the road, detective.
Whoa, that was weird. What do we do?
I'm trapped. I've got to get out of here.
I've got you, Nancy. You're cornered.
Take the ring off the monster arm?
You might as well give up.
Maybe. What does that do?
Ah!
Oh!
Ah!
As soon as I get out of here, I'm gonna call the police, Elliot. So don't bother making plans for tonight. Or the next 10 years.
She says, as soon as I get out of here.
Dear
you have Ned, a cell phone. You can
Elliot,
just call.
I managed to pry the exit open and had Harlan call the police. Elliot admitted to stealing the carousel horse and planting the remote control device. He knew that publicity from the hauntings would increase the value of his forgeries. Needless to say, he's gone back to not liking me. Harlan, on the other hand, adores me now, because not only did he share the credit for busting Elliot, but his sudden fame brought him 3 job offers. He's staying on at Captain's Cove out of loyalty to Paula, but he's happy knowing that being an ex-con will probably never be an issue for him again. As for Ingrid, she promptly attributed Elliot's bad behavior to a deficiency in some mineral I couldn't pronounce. And Joy, when I gave her the picture of her mother, she started smiling and has yet to stop.
Aww.
Inventing Miles was the best thing her late father could have done for her. In fact, when I went to the park to say goodbye just now, she wasn't in her office. She was riding the carousel.
Oh.
Ever yours, Nancy.
That's so cute. Oh my god, that's actually really cute. Hey, sassy detective. Congratulations on solving the haunted carousel case. Based on your cool sleuthing style, you are presented with the... Certificate of... Award? Recognition of reading everything you could get your hands on. Oh, I'm an avid reader. I sure am. Thanks. We did it! Yay!
You
do you have a trailer?
555-4468. I can't come to the phone right now, so please leave a message.
Hi, Bess. Hi, George. Well, thanks to you guys, I'm leaving here and flying directly to the Pacific Northwest for some much-needed R&R. George, I just got off the phone with that marine biologist friend of yours. She insisted I stay with her, and she even said she'd take me whale watching on the tour boat she owns. Anyway, thanks for arranging this little vacation, you two. One whole week of peace, quiet, and sitting around doing nothing. This is gonna be awesome. Bye.
Quiet vacation? I think not. As if. Danger on Deception Island. Ooh. Coming soon. Oh, exciting! So fun. That was super, super fun.
Thank you.